All right, it's Tuesday, March 23rd, 2010, and this is your Daily Dose. Just wanted to remind everybody that I myself will be out of the office this morning. I'm going to be taking off here in a few minutes. I'm going to go say goodbye to my friend, Mr. Edwin Zappel. Today is his ceremony. So we're going to go down and see that. Once again, for those of you that want to attend, I would encourage any licensed patient that's available. I understand that you may not know Edwin Zappel, you may not know his wife, you may not know his family, you may not know anybody at this church, and I understand that going to funerals can be uncomfortable, especially when it's people that you don't know. But I'd ask you to please, aside from the fact that that family is grieving, aside from the fact that the MCCNV family is grieving, please look at the big picture. We have a licensed patient that has passed without getting safe access to something that was written into the state constitution in 2000-2001. Every time we lose another one of these people without giving them something that should be inherent and it should just be an implicit given that if you're going to allow people to use it, have it, possess it, cultivate it, that they should also be allowed for those that can't to acquire it. Or at least acquire the means to start it. We have to keep fighting. And we have to show up to funerals like this, to raids, to arrests, to events. We have to. Do you think the news is going to show the good things that we're doing? Do you think the media does these things? No. They want to show what generates money, advertising, interest, so on and so forth. Therefore, the line between fact and fiction gets blurred a lot. And it's hard because most people's education comes from MSNBC, Fox, CBS, ABC, NBC. Like, some people just won't dig deeper. I was just blessed to be taught it a long time. I said, James, you can read everything. You can, whatever you do, research it all. But when you need to know something from somebody, go to them directly. Don't ask somebody what that person would say. Don't ask everybody, hey, what has that person said before? Go directly to them and find out what's cracking. And I'm telling you that we need to go directly to our elected officials every single day. Everybody that works for the city, everybody that works for the state. If you work for this state, you work for the people of Nevada. And if you notice something is wrong that's affecting the citizens, the people of Nevada, you got to be kidding me. Grow a sense of freaking community. Do something about it. Don't just say, oh, well, I work here in City Hall, or oh, I work here in taxation, or oh, I work here at the police department, or oh, I work here at the fire department. We work here in Nevada. This is our state, our community, and we need to do something about it. And our state, our community says medical marijuana is legal. It should also say that patients shouldn't have to die getting something the Constitution already should allow for. It's unacceptable. And every day, somebody who works for the state, somebody new in the community, an elected official, a business owner, somebody walking their dog, a child at the playground at the middle school, a high school teacher, I don't care who the hell you are. If you're in the state of Nevada and you realize that is something wrong that's affecting other Nevada residents, you can be selfish and shut up and not do anything. Or you can do something. I'm going to keep doing what I can do to make sure that medical marijuana patients get what we should have the right to from the Constitution. But yet it seems to avoid it as soon as you start having to deal with zoning and licensing and this and that, and all that gets twisted up. But I just wanted to remind everybody, we're going to be heading over, say our last respects to Mikey. I'm looking very forward to it. So we're going to go, the funeral ceremony starts at 11, and then there'll be a lunch afterwards at noon. This is at the Canyon Gate Ward of the LDS Church. And once again, that's today at 11 a.m., which is in about an hour and a half. And it's at 1801 South Monte Cristo Way. So if anybody can get out, don't have to speak or anything, just show up, stand, enjoy the beautiful day, enjoy the calm, peacefulness, and feel the energy. Funerals aren't always to be sad. Sometimes, you can celebrate. I know Mike's not here. I met Mike in May. I only got to know Mike for 10 months. But in those 10 months, I met a fighter, a patient that said, hey, I've given them all the chances they can give. They aren't helping me. We've got him legal. And for those last 10 months, Mike was able to enjoy what he was able to enjoy. And he did it on his terms. And I am just so grateful that that's the way it went down. Because it could have been different. He could have been forced to sit in his home and spend those last few months telling his caregivers, oh, I just wish there was something else. I wish there was this. Basically living out in pain. Instead, what little bit of life he was able to muster and get quality from, he was able to talk to people like me. Come down and see me. Learn about me so I could learn about him. He wasn't a criminal. He was sick. He was very sick. His kidneys didn't want to work anymore. His liver didn't want to work anymore. His body was giving up. Now, am I going to sugarcoat it and say that, hey, he ate nothing but, you know, chicken breasts and grilled vegetables his whole life? That he was clean and treated his body with the utmost respect throughout his life? No, I'm not going to say that. And neither would Mike. He would say, I lived. I did what I had to do. It affected me and me alone, except for the emotions of the people that are going to be sad when I'm gone. But I'm not angry. I just want to enjoy the time that I have. Didn't matter what you wanted to try to do. He knew what he wanted. He knew what made him feel good, and he did it. And he did it right up until his last breath. I only hope that I can be as lucky. If you're able, and I hope that I'm able, to live my life out to where at the end, before I'm finally out and no more, to be coherent and understanding of what's happening, to be cognizant of what's going on with my body, I only hope to be as lucky. I only hope to be able to say, when I'm dying, that, hey, you know what? Whatever it is that's going on inside this body of mine, it's me that's responsible. It's not you guys. I don't want you to care for me or anything like that. You don't have to. Let me care for me. Let the people that love me care for me when that time comes. Just make sure that you understand they're going to be caring for me with cannabis. Now I hope, once again, that people can get over and enjoy this last chance to say goodbye to Mike with me. I'll be back in the office this afternoon. I hope everybody's had a great start to the week. It's going to be another wonderful week here at MCCMV. We're very excited. I'm going to be very busy today. Like I said, we got to get that genetics list. That'll be done as soon as this gets done. And then I got hit with last second business licensing thing that has the utmost of my attention the second I return from this celebration. But after that, we'll get that genetics list posted so that 420 members will be able to have access to the Bombas genetics. All right, everybody, enjoy your day. We hope to see you at Mike Easy's celebration at 1801 South Monte Cristo Way at the Canyon Gate Ward LDS Church. That's today at 11 a.m. And then there's lunch at noon. And then I'll be back to the office this afternoon afterwards to get busy on that licensing task. All right, everybody, enjoy your day, and we'll see you tomorrow.